Look at that.
I want to live there.
This is, it's right. It's
I want to live there. Everything would be so much better.
It was so
welcome
cute.
To the neighborhood. Lego Maniacs, Matt Rogers is here, and I say that with all respect because I'm right there in the party with you. And his son, Braden, is here. They brought along with them the co-author of a book called The Lego Neighborhood, Brian Lyles. Welcome.
Yeah. Well, thanks for
good to have you
guys
here.
You take over for Mr. Rogers.
You could.
Yes.
You are
Seriously.
Mr. Rogers. This is your neighborhood. This is wonderful. Braden, are you a big Lego fan?
Yeah.
Yeah? Yeah. Do you typically play and then fall asleep and dad finishes the project?
No.
No.
It's actually the opposite, if I'm being honest here.
No, yeah. Which is why it was so fascinated when we heard of Brian's book is because after the Lego movie came out, Braden was a huge Lego fan. So, like I said, I'm always looking for stuff to do with my kid. And when I heard this, like, holy smokes. I mean, Brian, I'll let you talk about it a little bit more.
Yeah.
But
How did you get involved in the Lego world?
About 4 years ago, I went into Target looking for clearance toys for my son. And I ended up in the Lego aisle and bought some sets for my son. And I ended up putting them together. And after that, I quickly wanted to move into building bigger things. And I made these. And we ended up making instructions for them. And we sell them on our website. So that's kind of how we got started. We did that. And
wow.
That's awesome.
Well, you guys got busy earlier constructing this massive Mr. Rogers neighborhood, which is
Mr. Brian's neighborhood.
Right, it is
right.
Mr. Brian's
right.
neighborhood.
Yes.
Let's take a look.
Let's
take us through this.
Yeah.
Walk us through this.
I mean, Brian actually already put all of these buildings together right before we got here. We made some little touches on the cars and the people, but this is us setting it up. Obviously, that's Braden putting those small touches with the little people and having the, you know, the fun stuff. And I'm not great at this stuff, but.
No, but it's great, the interaction that you have with your child. That's wonderful.
See, he's sleeping right now.
Yeah, yeah. He wasn't even with you. He left you.
Boy,
I did a couple things, and then I passed out, and Braden took it over from there.
Clearly, the apple didn't fall far.
How difficult are these? Because the pieces are so small and intricate. Are these hard to put together?
Well, with big fingers like Matt's.
Sometimes they are. Like, I built one, and it was really fragile.
Oh.
I built a Ninjago set, and I built the big tower for it, like, all of them, and it was really fragile.
Well, it was really
fragile.
Yeah,
they are fragile,
but the cool
they're
thing
so cool.
It was really cool. The fragile ones, they break easily.
Yeah, well, they look really complicated. Can you show us how these buildings are put together?
Yeah, show us, Brian.
Yeah, I'm
going to
have Braden help me with this
Braden.
One. This one, we're actually going to be adding these pieces to the facade to make up the front of the building. And in the book, we actually show how to make this building, and we have instructions for several other facades that you can add to the same thing.
So I was gonna say, because we go Lego shopping for Braden all the time, you cannot buy these anywhere, right?
These are my designs, yep.
These are, you know, one of the things that I found very helpful working with my sons doing this, they're a little bit, they still play with them occasionally, but it's that process of seeing it and then trying to create it. So taking it from
the page
to go into that three-dimensional world. Mm-hmm. And you can see, like, Kai was a little bit better at it than Avery.
Right.
But and I would get frustrated. There are times I'm like, I can't do it.
What I do. I mean, putting this together, like he said, and, you know, Mark said, when you have large fingers, it's even harder. But, like, I know what I want to do, but it's hard. Reading through your book, I mean, there's stuff like this. Are you going to go forward and create more stuff? Like, is there stuff that's not in the book that you...
Definitely. We're still working on other projects, and we're also actually in the beginning stages of making our second book.
Really?
So, yeah.
Did we get a close-up shot of the
Santa?
Look at Santa.
This is great. This is so enchanting.
Wonderful. You can get more information on Brian's website, which is called BrickCityDepot.com. It's all there. Great instructions, because sometimes you want to have some direction. Otherwise, you're just sort of putting things together left and right.
You know, you ought to show us how to preserve all this in photographs, Mark.
I will. Good transition. I like what you did there.
Thank you.
Segway. I'm so
right.
proud.
Thank you.
I'm going to show you how you can make some wonderful family portraits. We're going to get you to step one notch out of that auto setting on your camera. It's called AV mode. I'm going to tell you all about it. Don't be afraid.